Well, we want to welcome everyone to another evening conversation. I'm glad that all of you that are able to be here live are here. And for those that watch it later or those that are just listening tonight, we just thank you for your connection. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for this time together this evening after we have celebrated your resurrection day. Father, we are so grateful for your sacrifice of your son, the ultimate act of generosity that you gave his life in order that we can be in relationship with you. We are humbled by that. We are grateful for it. And I pray, Father, that as we navigate this world, that we would be bold enough to tell others what you did. So, Father, I pray for our time this evening. I pray that as we gather together, that you would be seen in and through it. We would be an encouragement to one another as we connect. We thank you for this time. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right. How was everybody's Easter weekend? This is what I want to know. I want to know what happened. I'm going to fill you in eventually on something that happened at a local church here. And I'd like you to just share with me how your Easter weekends were, whether it was a personal thing that went really well for you, or whether it was something at your ministry that you felt that God was present. So I'm just going to open it up and ask that you would do that. And Ray, it's so great to see you.
Thank you. It's good to see you too.
Good, good. Yeah. What's been happening in your world, in your life?
Mine specifically?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just allowing the Lord to work in me. And the past couple years have been rough for me, so spiritually. And so it's just doing a lot of inward and stirring of the Lord, and just allowing the Lord to work in me to move me and back into a right relationship with him. And so I feel like I'm ready to be used by him again. So.
That's an okay place to be, Ray. Yeah. You know, the inner work is the hardest work, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so how was your weekend with your family for Easter?
It was great. We all got together and as our family, my sisters and parents and a lot of the grandkids, not all of them, but a lot of them were there, and we just had a really good time and the family and all together. And service was excellent, and it's a powerful sermon and all given, and it moved and
good. Yeah,
really good.
That's good. That's good. An encouragement to you. Mm-hmm. Good. That's good. Howard, how about you? How were things down there, and how was worship, and how was your Easter?
Very good. Like that, it was a just unique. Several things. And I'm not going to talk like I did last time, so I
almost won't
talk half hour. But as a pastor, you feel so wonderful. I planned my sermons on my outline down mountain. Basically, what I'm going to do, you know, by Thursday, I'm typing like that type of thing. Well, Friday, last 3 weeks, Friday came to bed. You're not supposed to preach yet. And it's not terrifying. That's a wonderful feeling.
Is it?
It really is. You just know that God's speaking to you, that you just know that you know what you're supposed to preach. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying that in arrogance. I'm just saying it's just so good to know that God trusts you with the word. Okay. And that's exciting like that. Well, we had a good service. We had not sneered. The elders wanted to have a sunrise service, and we did. When we had 18 people there, not a big crowd, but they were outside, enjoyed immensely. Afterwards, couple of the older people, they made arrangement that we could go to the Golden Corral and have breakfast together. Nice. And 14 of the 18 went to the Golden Corral. So we ate fellowship together like that. And then the worship service was wonderful. It's just a good spirit, a good positive spirit. Numbers not like we want like that, but I don't know that any of us pastors are going to be satisfied with number. We have 102, we want one more or like that. I think we should be that way in many ways. I do want to say something. Not with your question, I have to say this. My wife celebrated her birthday today. This is the third birthday she's had since the doctor gave her 6 weeks to live.
Wow.
And I have to praise the Lord that the doctor said 6 weeks, but the good Lord's given her an additional 3 years. And I have to say that as a testimony like that. It's been good.
That's amazing.
Wonderful. You know, it's just amazing how the Spirit's so wonderful. I don't know how to say it, just in the church, when you get outside the church, you know, I went to Wendy's, and the lady were talking like that and talking about a good day like that, and, you know, and anyway, she said, well, blessings to you, and said, well, praise the Lord for you, and says, oh, you're a Christian. Well, yeah, so are you. So it was just a brief conversation that you could just, you were encouraged. Mm-hmm. The family that God's moving, even you don't know them. Mm-hmm. And you know where it's happening. The family is God's moving, and that's just, it. It's just a positive thing. And I'll be quiet now. All right.
Now, I mean, oh my goodness, that's so wonderful that you gave that testimony about Vicki, because I remember when she was really, really ill, and you know, for her to defy what the earthly doctors would say because her physician said no, it's really, really cool. Yeah, yeah. Thanks for that, Howard. That's great. Did you get to see her on Easter?
Not Easter, the day before, Friday. I get to see her for a half hour through a plastic shield and wave at her and talk to her like that. Can't touch her. It's funny. I can buy something for her. I can't give it to her, but I can give it to the nurse who walks around the corner and gives it to her.
Yeah.
It makes sense to me, but that's red tape and like that. So.
Yeah. Aw, God bless her. That's great. That's really, really great. John, how were things up there in both of your congregations for the Easter weekend for Resurrection Day? Any testimonies that you can give?
Oh, I'll tell you, for, you know, just like anybody coming out, kind of same thing. Howard just said, I mean, we had a sunrise service. Mercersburg, we do it here at the campground. And, I tell you, just it really shines as the blessings. And what I got to thinking was, so where we're at is kind of like on the top of the hill or a little ways up the mountain, if you will. And so when you look to where the sunrise is, it's almost like a valley.
Oh, wow.
That comes up over by Greencastle. And as we were sitting out there and we were looking at it and we were thinking, what I can think of is like Jerusalem looking over the Kidron Valley to the Mount of Olives, because it's farmland. And so I was like, you know, the Garden of Gethsemane, you know, what's it going to be like? Hmm. And then the sun popped up, that bright orange, early morning glow color. And it was a beautiful service. And then it went behind the clouds. And then about 20 minutes later, it came on top of the clouds. Bright yellow, you know, the bright yellow sun of the day. Mm-hmm. And so it's like getting blessed with two sunrise services for one. It just reminds us how well God blesses. Mm-hmm. Both the churches compared to where we've been over the last year, especially Blair's. And we focused a lot on singing and praising God. So we had like everybody that sings special, we like got all of them to do a special on Easter or on Resurrection Sunday. That's just because this needs to be a celebration. Right. It needs to be a different service. And so the focus was on them singing songs, you know, the cross. One of the ladies that attends at Blair's Valley, her mom attends at Mercersburg, and she sang a special at Blair's Valley. And then after church, I invited her to come to Mercersburg to spend Easter with her mom and sing a special. And so she actually sang at both churches.
Wow.
But the number of grandkids that I haven't seen in years, you know, they were there when it was the whole thrill of getting a new pastor. And then they've kind of like winged it off. But to come in and to be with mom and dad and grandma on Easter, it was very emotional. It was very packed, and it was very much a celebration. Now wore me out. I'm not gonna lie. Too powerful, emotional. God was present. Well, three services because I did the sunrise. I don't know. I think it was Pat who had the cat that was like laid out and said all the pastors, you know, that's the first time I've ever been that worn out on a Sunday, nor, you know, I told Pam, I felt like I was back in the Marine Corps and I just got done running a physical test. My joints, that was my offering for prayer. You know, Lord, if all times people are here that need to hear the gospel, right. You know, clear my heart, use me. And I mean, you know, when you say that and he shows up and you just give it all you got. And it was very impactful. You know, I preached Matthew 7, the two roads, which road, you know, wide and narrow is the way and narrow is the gate and Jesus is the way. And that was the message that we had. You've got to come to a decision on what road you're going to travel. And it was a very good Sunday. I'm a little fearful for this Sunday. Hopefully they come back and we've changed not only minds, but we've changed hearts and eternities.
You just need to be obedient.
What a day.
The rest is up to God.
This is where I was given Howard that weird face when he was, I was gonna say, this is where I was given Howard that weird face when he says that you know, God changed your message. You know, I prefer it when he does it on Thursday, not on Friday. But then I get mad because our biggest downfall, and here's why. Our biggest downfall is we get in the way.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
If we would have gotten out of the way on Wednesday and listened to God, because when he does that, he gives you the message, everything. But no, we have to keep plugging through to like Saturday afternoon, the message I want to give. And, but then it's like owning a Toyota when you're like, when you get out of the way and say, okay, God, what do you want? The earlier in the week you do it, you surrender, as you were saying, Colleen. You know, when God uses that, it's amazing.
Yeah, so, it becomes really an out-of-body experience when you do that, when you're obedient to that. You know, it's like you don't even know what you said when you sit down. It's a beautiful thing. That's so great. Oh, thank you so much, John. I'm excited for you. It's wonderful. Pat, how about you? How were things up there in Mount Carmel?
Normal. I mean, we didn't gather last year, so it was good to gather this year.
Yeah,
we had 18 turned out.
Good.
And they all get to miss, and for those that didn't make it out, we made a joke, get to miss seeing me in my yearly suit and tie. I'm a suit Christian. I only wear it on holidays and funerals. That's it. Stays in the closet.
Oh, that's so great, though.
Now, my heart's right now with Ashley. She came through the surgery after 3.5 hours.
That was long. Was it expected to be that long?
No. Damage was worse than they expected.
Yeah.
She had to have spinal fusion in her neck, so she'll never be able to turn her head again.
Mm-hmm.
The only way she'll be able to turn is with her waist, I guess. That was explained. Mm-hmm. They had to remove a couple of corrupted discs, and they're hoping this might be it. I mean, 3-4 surgeries now. It's just praying. So,
but it should take care of her pain. They're hopeful, or
they're hoping. They're hoping this. The damage, I guess, it was real bad this time. It was worse than the X-rays showed in the CAT scan.
Yeah, they never know.
But it was really cool because I was told that the doctor prayed with her prior to surgery.
That's so wonderful.
I was just like, that was like mind blowing. I've never heard of a doctor praying with you at all. But that was so, you know, God was right there in the waiting room.
Right.
And then Howard was this crazy part that just touched my heart too, you know. So mm-hmm. I really ain't got much to say because I'm worn out. I had to work with Dan today. I'm a little tired.
Yeah, that's exhausting. Oh, did you do the podcast with Dan?
Yeah.
Oh, God bless
you. Howard was there.
Oh, Howard was too?
Yeah, he was down there typing and critiquing, I hope.
Good. That's good. Oh, that's great. Yeah, I was so grateful that Ashley Dawn did a really, she had this major surgery today to fix her shunt, I believe, and neck. And, you know, 3 hours later, they're hopeful for her recovery. So keep praying, keep for her in prayer and her mother as she cares for her. Yeah, it's really good. It's really good. Daniel, how
are you? Down by Howard somewhere. I don't know what hospital she's in, but she's near Howard there somewhere.
Best hospitals in the world there.
That's what you put on Facebook, so it must be true. How about you, Daniel? How are things up in Altoona, Daniel?
We went back to our regular services. So we had early breakfast and the normal service. Mm-hmm. Probably a little more than maybe 60% of normal attendance everywhere, all time. So it was nice. Mm-hmm. I mean, quite a few of us have vaccines now and so on. So we don't worry too much. And right now here in Altoona, whoever wants a vaccine can get the vaccine. So.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. In fact, now they start to make it work. They want everybody to get it and they start making lists, meaning that those who are not going to take it are going to have problems. But that's how it goes. I mean,
yeah.
I take a flu shot every year, not because I want one, because I want to go play music in a nursing home.
Right.
So I guess if I take a flu shot, I take the COVID shot too, whatever.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a prerequisite for something.
Oh, yeah. If you want to travel, I mean, flying, whatever. It's quiet Easter. We didn't invite each other at homes like we usually do. And we did services.
Well, good. That's really good. Rich, you're back from your vacation with your grandson.
I am.
Did you have a really good Easter with them?
We did. We had a great time. My one and only grandson, who just turned 1 year old, 1 year old on the 19th of March, so just recently. So he had his spring break. When I heard he had a spring break, I thought, what are they going to Florida?
Preschoolers going to spring break.
Preschool. But the school that actually have grades up through grade 4 where he's at. So I think it's a school break, you know, but it was just funny. But they needed, so by us going out there, then my daughter and her husband could both keep working. They work from home, but they didn't have to take vacation days and they got to see us. So it worked out really well. We got to spend the days Monday to Friday with my grandson, Owen, and got to see them. So we were out there about 11 days, I guess, all together.
That's wonderful.
We had a good time. Yeah. So
he's beautiful.
It was odd. I mean, everybody's talking, of course, about services and stuff, but we just stayed home on Easter. And there was a time, there was actually a time in the morning I wanted to go online and see a service. But in my head, I thought of the whole walking past the guy on the side of the road kind of thing, the good Samaritan stopped. But anyway, I thought, you know, this is a Sunday was, we left Monday. I thought, I need to spend this day with my daughter. I mean, we're prayed up and everything, and I worship lots. And I'm not saying I didn't want to be at somewhere, but they got their first vaccinations. My daughter and her husband, but they're being exceptionally careful because there's no vaccine for their 1 year old yet.
There's not.
But they're not going to do much until that happens, which will be next year, hopefully early.
Right. Whatever. You can't blame them.
No, I can't. So we're being safe. I mean, we drove all the way out, but we wore a mask every time go in to find a bathroom or get gas or grab something to eat from the fast food. But anyway, we had a great time there. It was
good.
Great to be with them.
Easter Sunday, your worship was with your family. I mean, that was. I mean, and I think that those of us that grew up in the church. We grew up with this mindset that you went to church. So you went to Sunday school, you went to church, you went to Sunday evening church, you went to Wednesday evening church. And there was like this checkbox thing, you know?
Yeah.
And it's bigger than that. You know, I mean, I really think that for you, that was really important that you spent that time with your family. I had a different time like that too. I did worship online on Sunday and it was really great. And I find when I worship with my church online, there's this intimacy that I have and freedom that I have that I might not necessarily have in person.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of like that, but my time was, over the weekend, I got to be with all my grandchildren. It was so fun. It was just so great. And then I needed to take a meal to my daughter who had to work on Sunday. And that was worship to me too, where I got to sit outside with her while she took a break from being a physician's assistant for, a half an hour. And I took her her Easter dinner and, just spent time with her too. So I really felt very worshipful, you know, and then we had an elderly retired. Well, actually, her husband was my pastor growing up, and she lives in Steelton. And so we picked her up and she came to dinner with us and at home. And that was such a blessing, you know, for me, you know, to spend a couple hours with a woman who, you know, was very influential in my growing up years, you know, as her husband, as my pastor. He's passed away now, but that was really special to me, you know, to have her here in our home.
Oh, yeah.
And I did hear from one of the churches locally here in Harrisburg who that pastor was super excited because he had two professions of faith in house and one online.
Nice.
So I'm telling you, we got to think so far outside of the four walls, you know, because God is doing a new thing. Right. And we should all be excited about that. And, you know, Ray, I'm really excited for you, for whatever God's doing inside of you. You know, he's not done with you yet. Obviously, you're not dead. You're still breathing. And he has a plan. And, you know, for all of us that we would not fear doing things differently, like John, you know, I think it's really awesome that Mercersburg would come to your community where you are living in your camper when it's warm enough. You know, that they would come there for a sunrise service, and you don't know the people in that, if there were people there in the campground, you know, if you ever do that again, who you might meet and who might find Jesus because you do that, you know.
If it's camping season, like the last time we actually had it, if it was camping season, they actually advertise it in the camper, and campers here show up.
Yeah.
Not because we didn't have it last year, but the year before, we had what, 6 people? From,
I don't know what you're talking about.
For sunrise service.
Hi, Pam.
There was 8 of them here.
Four couples from that were camping came down to the field where we did our sunrise service and participated.
Fantastic.
I mean,
and one of the families came
beautiful.
Yeah, it's so great. Yeah, it's just really great. So no matter where you were this weekend, you know, I think you can all testify to that you saw God. And, you know, however that looked, you know, whether you wore a suit or you didn't.
Yeah. Wear that suit, man.
I'd like to see that. Actually, it's funny. On my phone, whenever Gilbert Thurston ever calls me, I have a picture on there of him in a suit because he never wears a suit. He stopped by the office because he was going to a funeral. And I had to take a picture of him because he's always in a t-shirt. And, you know, so I actually captured that. So, Pat, I'd like a picture of you in your suit. I can put it on my phone. So, all right. Well, it's just so great to be with all of you. And I hope that you have a wonderful week. Yeah, go ahead, Howard.
Yeah, I'm doing it about old school. I have to wear a suit. That's what they want. I'm not going to fight it. That's what they want. I'll wear it. Okay, sure. That's not a problem.
Like You're a good man.
In this July, 50 years ago, I met Reg Thornton at summer seminar.
What?
I didn't get a card from him or anything like that. Didn't mean we like each other for 50 years, but we knew each other for 50 years. Reg, I'm teasing. But 50 years ago, 1971, was when we first met. And we first met on a piano bench singing a course.
At a piano bar? Is that what you're saying?
In a course.
Oh.
Okay. It was a bunch of, we were with the youth and like that. And we met the first time singing a chorus,
Technically
together, but probably not really together, but we were singing, okay? And that's and I thought of that, and we lost contact with it, but I want to say it's a privilege. I'm thanking God that I've known you for 50 years. Even we haven't kept together, we're still friends, we still acknowledge each other, and God's still using us. So I want to say praise the Lord for that.
Oh, that's so cool.
Thanks, Howard. Yeah, when I get a chance to see you or hear what's going on with you or with you, I'm just thinking, it's like, you know, it's good to have new friends, but it's like, you know, when you know somebody a long time, that's really cool. You know,
awesome.
Yeah. I just can't understand why you've aged and I haven't.
What's that?
I can't understand why you aged and I haven't.
it's Zoom. Like some people put backgrounds on them. I put the foreground in, and that's all. When you see me in person, next time you'll be shocked.
Sure, I will be. Sure, be. God bless the ministry.
Oh, that's so, that was wonderful. I'm glad you said that, Howard. That's so great. Yeah, the connections are wonderful. It's really great. Rich, I was wondering, would you close us in prayer this evening?
Sure. Be happy to.
Thank you.
Dear God, I thank you for this time to be together. Thank you for the joy that we share, the pains that we share as well, the burdens that we share, that we give all that to you. And we give you all that and you give us joy. And in the evenings when we don't feel the joy, we know that it's coming in the morning. We thank you that right now we're sensing your joy. But we know there are difficulties too, just like I have a brother-in-law who's in the hospital with COVID. Other people have other family members and other people that they know that are suffering, Lord, that we're praying for. So we do pray for them. We pray for all kinds of people right now, for people who have lost loved ones. But we thank you that you brought us through and that we're continuing on serving you 50 years and more, and still just try to be faithful, Lord. Just try to be faithful. Whatever time is that we have, we just want to be faithful to you. So I thank you for each one on this call. For those who will be watching, I ask you to bless them as well. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thanks, everybody. I hope you have a good night. And Ray, it was really wonderful to see you. Tell your wife I said hello. Have a good night.
Will do. You too. The same. Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.